Security's gotten so bad now, I just show up to the airport in a G-string. I'm like, hey, guys, up?
The character I read for was terrorist number four. Not number one, not number two, number four. And I was already well into my comedy career at this point, so I didn't take it that serious. And I read my lines way over the top. And, you know, I was like, sit down, you little bear, I'll kill you in the name of Allah, you know, stuff like that. And the director went nuts, and he was like, that was brilliant, Ahmad. Let me see you do it again, but this time with more, you know, Arab, you know how your people are very, you know, he's trying to say that we're angry. And I was just like, okay, angry, is that what you want? Yes, yes. So I did it one more time, and I got a call the next morning that they want to use me in this movie. And I started laughing on the phone because I wasn't even, like, I was making fun of the role. I wasn't trying to be like that. And that's what they want, though.
And once we begin to humanize Arabs and Muslims, to project them as we project other people, no better, no worse, then the stereotype gradually diminishes. In movies such as A Perfect Murder, we see an Arab-American detective befriend the heroine. Then there's Three Kings, a movie I served as a consultant on. The action occurs during the first Gulf War in 1991. The film is notable for revealing the complexities of the Iraqi people, focusing on decent Iraqis that Saddam Hussein wants to kill.
How's your little girl?
She's safe from now.
Outstanding, excellent. How can we help you?
There's mutual respect in this film. And there's also Iraqis who are loyal to Saddam Hussein. It's not a sugar-coated film. It's a very realistic film. It's an outstanding film, in my opinion. Kingdom of Heaven, which focuses on the Crusades, was a tremendous hit overseas, not here in the United States. And when the film was shown in Beirut, particularly at the end, when Salah ad-Din takes over Jerusalem, there's peace between Muslim and Christian. He enters a church and there is an icon on the floor. Salah ad-Din sees the icon, respectfully picks it up, and places it back on the altar. When audiences in Beirut saw that, they rose to their feet and applauded. We're talking about Muslims as well as Christians applauding the act of a Muslim who embraces religious tolerance. There is this need of Arab audiences to embrace American films that show them in a respectful, honest, fair manner. And with the release of George Clooney's Syriana, I have hope that Hollywood may be listening. The film has some unflattering yet honest depictions of Arabs, but it also presents an Arab prince as one of the film's few decent human beings. The British-educated prince wants to bring democracy to his country, and his ideals get him and his family murdered.
I want to create a parliament. I want to give women the right to vote. I want an independent judiciary. I want to start a petroleum exchange in the Middle East. I'll put all of our energy up for competitive bidding. I'll run pipe through Iran to Europe, like you proposed. I'll ship to China. Anything that achieves efficiency and maximizes profit. Profit, which I will then use to rebuild my country.
Great, that's exactly what you should do.
Exactly. Except, your president rings my father and says I've got unemployment in Texas, Kansas, Washington State. One phone call later, we're stealing out of our social programs in order to buy overpriced airplanes.
Another example of this kind of humanity and respect is found in Hideous Kinky, a film about an English woman, played by Kate Winslet, and her two daughters in Morocco. Winslet's relationship with her Moroccan lover is beautifully and lovingly displayed. And when she doesn't have the money to return home to England with her daughters, he makes hard sacrifices to make it happen. There's a tender and moving scene at the end. The Moroccan catches up with the train they're on to say goodbye, to wish them well. We see the warmth and love that exists between them. Ella!
And nowhere is this kind of humanity more visible than in the film Paradise Now, written and directed by Hani Abu Assad. Two Palestinian friends get recruited to carry out a suicide bombing on Tel Aviv. At first, they accept their mission solemnly, but they're intercepted at the Israeli border and separated from their handlers. Then a young woman realizes their plan and forces them to question their action.
مش حرية بدون كفاح. لازم حدا يضحي بحاله. طول ما في ظلم واحتلال في تضحية.
هذا مش تضحية. هذا انتقام. هيك بتقتل وبتصير زيهم. وببدل في الفرق بين الضحية والقتل.
الفرق انه بطل في
These three young Palestinians are different from each other. They're not just crazed terrorists. And they're not just freedom fighters. They're human beings. With all the faults, successes, ideals and pain. Of human being.
سعيد رد علي.
كان ليش انت هون؟ ايش جيت؟
عشان اكون معاك. تعال نرجع. سوا مع حق. مش حننتصر بهي الطريقة.
احنا نعمل اللي علينا. نجتهد وباك على الله.
بس ربنا قال لك فكر قبل ما تعمل. رايحين نموت ونموت ناس معانا، مش رح يتغير ولا اشي.
مش موطن رح اغير. تكملة نضال هي رح تغير. انا ما عنديش خيار تاني على التكملة.
لازم تغير شي شي. رد لازم تغير شي شي.
I'm an optimist and I believe in the future, particularly in young filmmakers. The stereotype will change. It will change because young men and women who are entering the profession will see that there has been a grave injustice committed and they'll make attempts to correct it. It's only a matter of time as to when this will happen, but it will take place. Look, we've unlearned many of our prejudices against blacks, Native Americans, Jews, other groups. Why can't we unlearn our prejudices against Arabs and Muslims? What matters is not to remain silent. I think whenever we see anyone being vilified on a regular basis, we have to speak out. Whether we're image makers or not, we have to take a stand and say this is morally and ethically wrong